What's up, my blazing beauties? I'm back at it with another video. I wanted to give you guys a more spicy Valentine's Day look. So if you like this, make sure to keep watching to see how I did it. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to support your girl. I really appreciate it. I love you all, and I hope that you have an amazing Valentine's Day. Hey guys, we're gonna start with brows, and I'm using the chocolate eyebrow pomade by Gold Armoire. Then I'm gonna take my spoolie to work that around in the eyebrow. I wanna make sure that they look fluffy and real. Next, I'm using the Florence by Mills Dewy Moisturizer to get my skin prepped and move on to the next product. For eyeshadow, I'm using my Gold Armoire palette in a fluffy brush to work in two shades, an orange and a red. I'm going to go into the crease and onto the lid to make sure that I'm blending this out right. I'm also not using a primer because I don't want the color to be very pigmented at all. I'm using windshield wiper motions to make sure that I really blend those colors out for a smooth transition on the eye. Then I use my Florence by Mills under eye cream to prep that area. I really work that in, and then I use my fingers to get it in so that it really sinks into the skin and hydrates that dry area under my eye. Next, for the skin, I'm using the Yenza Essential Glow Tone Up Primer to prep my skin for a smooth application of foundation. This primer is amazing, and I like to use my hands to rub it in to warm up the product. For foundation, I'm using one of my favorites by MAC Cosmetics. It's the Pro Long Wear Waterproof Foundation. It's full coverage and is really easy to blend in. I'm using my Real Technique Buffer Brush to just work that into the skin all over. I did not color correct or use any concealers before applying this. Again, I just wanted to show how great the coverage was. And then after, I'm going to apply two different concealers, Tarte Shape Tape and Infallible by L'Oreal. First, I'm going to start with the L'Oreal, and I'm just working this under my eye and the peaks of my face where I really want to apply that. I'm using my Real Techniques Diamond Sponge to work that into my skin, and I take my time to blend because I want to make sure that the transition between my concealer and my foundation are as flawless as possible. This is key to making sure that it doesn't look like you have a mask on. To set my highlight, I'm using the Peach Perfect Loose Powder by Too Faced. I love it. It really does smell like peach candy almost. And I'm applying it on top of that concealer and just letting it bake for a little bit to make sure that looks wonderful. To set my face, I'm using NC42 Studio Fix Powder by MAC Cosmetics. And then I'm just using a Real Technique brush to rub that into my skin. I'm working that into my skin everywhere I don't have the baking. And then I'm going to use a 35 NC by MAC to go on top of the areas where I have the loose powder for baking. I don't want to mess up my highlight. Next, I'm going to use the LA Pro Concealer to do my contour. I love this concealer. It comes out liquid. It's a great price point, and it's really easy to buff into the skin. But sometimes it kind of dries up fast. So what I'll do is I'll use a spray, and I'll use it on my brush to make sure that I can hydrate the areas and buff that in even easier in the areas where I really want it to melt into the skin. For blush, I'm going to use my contour palette by Clarins and just work that on the ball of my cheek and pull it up. Here is the big one, my lashes. These are by Gold Armoire, hands down my favorite lashes. Use my code Beauty in the Blazer to order yours. Prep your lashes by applying a little mascara. Kind of pick up some eyeshadow color if you lost some, because remember, we don't have a primer. And pop those right on. I use my hands to apply because my nails are always done. I always go back in with an eyeliner to make sure that I go on top of that strip for a smooth transition. I don't want you to be able to see where the lash line starts, so it works. For my lips, I'm going to use cherry liner to start off and just carve out my shape. You guys know I really love to overdraw my lip. This is also matted, so it works really well to get started. And this is a very vibrant red that we're going for, a very sultry Valentine's Day look. I'm going to go ahead and fill that lip in on the edges, and then I'm going to take my Gold Armoire Charming Lip Stain and fill in the centers. This is a really pretty color. And then once that dries down, I add my Dior lip gloss on top for a little bit of an extra shine and an extra pop. So I'm going for a little sexy. I wanted to add a little bit more of a darkness and a defined eye. This is my NYX pencil. And then I just take a flat brush and add the same colors and shades that I used in my crease above on the bottom to smoke out the under eye area and have a cute transition. This is my favorite part. This is the Cleo Highlighter by Juvia's Place. I'm gonna use a small brush to work it into the corners of my eye for the extra pop. I love this because it really opens up the eye. With my fan brush, I'm gonna go on top of the bone and of my cheek and work that out so that I can make sure I have that pop as well. I'm using Bad Gal Lash on the bottom by Benefit. And then to finish, Mario Badescu.
No, but for real, happy Valentine's Day, my loves. I hope you guys have an amazing day full of love. Remember to give love everywhere you go. If you're spending time with that special someone, with your family, with your friends, if you're at work, it doesn't matter. You know, giving love is the easiest thing that we can do. So make sure that you love on somebody today. Do something kind, do something nice. And don't forget to learn how to receive love. Make sure you love on yourself. That is number one, okay? So peace, love, and blessings. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you have an amazing Valentine's Day. I love you guys so much.